Hello, it's Keith here and it's lesson 8 of the Super Simple series. Today we're going to look at drawing a simple bitmap graphic on the Super Nintendo or the Super Famicom, of course, at the same system. So let's go and have a look at the source code and we'll see today's example in action. Over we go. And here it is. Well, before we talk about it, let's check it actually works, because sometimes they don't. Sometimes there's a bug crept in. So let's fire that up. And we're going to be doing the Super Nintendo this time, so off we go. Now, you can see there's some corruption in the background, and that's because I'm using Mesen here, which is very cunning, and it fills the entire RAM area with corruption to make it really work for getting your test code working correctly. And I haven't bothered clearing the video RAM in this example, so you can see there's a load of garbage, but you can also see just there, there's a little smiley face. It's very small, but it is there. And so that's the first example we're doing, just a single tile, just one 8x8 tile. And the idea is that that's kind of a very, very minimal example. But if you wanted, you could create multiple tiles and have kind of a little battle game going on, or a Pac-Man, you know, whatever you wanted. And of course, the first thing you could maybe do is create a blank tile and then fill that background in with it. But as I say, this example, I've not bothered to do that, so never mind. Anyway, that's the first example, just a single tile. But then we're going to extend it a little bit more with the advanced example. And we're going to draw our Chibi character. There it is. So that's our mascot for these tutorials. And we're going to get that onto the screen. So we've got two nice examples there. And we're going to look at the source code for both. Now, the first thing with the Super Nintendo is I define a bunch of zero page entries that kind of look like Z80 registers, because I was a Z80 programmer before I was a 6502 programmer. So it makes things a little bit easier for me. So we've got a HL pair for source, BC for byte count, and DE for destination. And we've got our ROM starting at 8000 here, just turning the interrupts off, and we're just setting up our screen here. I did cover a lot of this code in my previous Hello World example, so we're gonna go a little quickly over that. If you don't know anything about starting a NES file, don't know how to build a file, don't know how to run it, well, first you can download the source and all of the pre-configured stuff from my website, but please have a look at that episode, because I'm sure that you're gonna find some stuff that's really gonna help you get started in there. So we'll go over this a little bit quickly, and you can just take my word for it. This is a valid introduction to starting a file, getting the screen set up. And here we're just defining our colors. Black here, that's gonna be a kind of purple. That's cyan, and that's white here. You can see the red, green, blue components here. And we're just storing a color number to 2121, and then the color data to 2122 here. That's just setting things up. And then here, we're just setting up our screen VRAM writing here, because we need to set up how it increments as we write our byte pairs. So we're setting it up in the way that these tutorials are expecting it. There are multiple options, you see. Setting up the scroll position of our tile map, just setting it back to so that the top left tile is the first one in VRAM. Otherwise, we might have to make some more complex changes to our calculations. And here we're clearing the tile map, but the tile zero hasn't actually been defined. It was in my Hello World example, but I took the code out that was doing that just to make this one simple. But it means that we've got all of this corruption on screen. So if I'd actually filled tile zero with some zeros, that would have gone, it looks like. So never mind there. Anyway, so here we're turning on the screen. We're just turning on tile map one. And here we're just setting the brightness to maximum. Very good. And then this is the point where we're actually starting to set up our smiley face. I'll just get the correct example running here. We're not running the Chibico example here. We're running the smiley face example. And there it is. There's that smiley face. So let's see the smiley face. Where is it? Here it is. Now, the NES was a 2-bit per pixel system, but the Super Nintendo is a 4-bit per pixel system. And the layout is a little bit weird, as you can see. Now, it works in what's known as bit planes, and I've got a typo here. This should be 3 and 2, and this should be 1 and 0. So the reason that bit plane 0 comes after bit plane 1 is the layout of the ports I've selected here. If you remember, I said before we were setting up the port control here, and the settings I've done here means that we write to the high byte before we write to the low byte here. Now, if we'd set it the other way around, these would be the other way. But as I say, the way it's set up, this is the format we would need. So the bit one comes first for a line, then the bit zero. We then repeat for all 8 lines of the tile, and then we start again with bit three and bit two for the same 8 lines of the tile. Now, the tile example we're seeing is just a 4-color tile. So bit planes 2 and 3 have no data in them, but bit plane 0, because the background of the smiley, the body of the smiley face, if you will, is all in color 1, And the eye, the mouth is in colour 2 and the eyes are in colour 3. And that's why you can see a 1 here and a 1 here. Because if bit 0 and bit 1 are both 1, then you will add up to 3 if you know your binary. So that's how we're doing that. We've got a bitmap end and we use that to calculate the length of the bitmap and put that into BC. And then we're going to define the tiles. We need to select the address that we're writing our tiles to. The tile patterns start at 1000 and tile 128 is 1800. The reason we're starting at 128 is in some examples we would have wanted to load that font in from the Hello World example, but just to make this as minimal as possible, I haven't done that, and that's why we've got all of that corruption on the screen. Silly me. So we're doing this define tiles. Let's have a look at it. Here it is. So we've got a function called prepare VRAM. What this does is it selects a memory address from DE. It's just down here. It's very simple. We wait for VBlank, which means looping until the top bit of 4212 is non-zero, and that will mean we're in VBlank. And then what we do is we just write the destination address to 2116 and 2117 here. And once we've done that, we're now in a position where we can actually write the data. So the way we're doing that is just here. It's just very straightforward here. We're loading in a byte from HL, the source data, storing it to 2119, waiting for VBlank again, just in case we've gone out of it, because we might have just caught the very end of the VBlank. So we just need to double check before we write each byte, reading in another byte and writing it. And we're just repeating here until Y equals zero. When it does, we're then increasing HL here and we're just looping again until BC reaches zero. Now, because we're using Y effectively as the low byte counter, we never need to increment L here. And we also don't need to decrement C. So we're kind of saving some efficiency there just by doing that. We're using X as our C and Y as our offset counter for this just here. So that's what we're doing. It works okay. So that's defining our tiles. And then what we need to do is we actually need to select the video RAM address for the tile that's in the position we want to set the smiley to. So let's find that. Just here. Now there are 32 tiles per line in the organization that we've defined it. So each tile needs 2 bytes, but the addresses are actually in words. So effectively what we need to do is multiply the Y position by 32, add the X position, and that will calculate the position within the VRAM for the tile we want to change. And that's what we're doing here. We're calculating it, waiting for that VBlank. And then we're storing the address we want to write to by writing the low byte to 2116 and the high byte to 2117. Okay, so we've selected our address here. We're going to wait for another VBlank because we're getting very paranoid here. And then what we're doing is we are going to write the actual tile number to the screen, to the tile map. And the tile we're going to write is 128. So the tile definitions use a total of 2 bytes. Some of it, the top byte is tile number, some of it's palette information and flipping and things. So we're just going to write all of the first byte to 0 and then the low byte, which is the tile number from 0 to 255, we're going to write as number 128. And that's because we defined it to tile 128 via this memory address just here. And that will actually draw our tile to the screen, as you've seen with that smiley. So that's all there is to it. It's a little bit complicated, but unfortunately that's what it tends to be like on these cartridge systems, which have no firmware to get anything set up for us. Okay, so we've written our tile 128 to video RAM, and that gets our smiley on the screen. So let's have a look at that more advanced example then. So it's very straightforward really, it's pretty much the same. Let's just fire it up just one more time. There's our Chibi Character. It's good to see that back again. Just get it out of the way. So where's this image come from? Well, before we were defining it as bitmap data within the actual source file, well, it's going to get a bit silly this time. If we did that, we could, but we're not going to. We're including the file here as a ink bin file, raw SNES. So the question becomes, where can we get a valid file for the format of this example? Well, my Acrosprite editor, free open source sprite editor here, can do that for you. So I used it to create today's example. You can see we've got the Chibi Code character just here. And if we go to 6502 and we go to Super Nintendo Save Raw Bitmap, that will export this character as a bitmap that today's example can work with. So if you want to change the bitmap, you can use my Acrosprite editor with my example, and hopefully that'll be a good starting point for you. So you can see here that this is a 48 foot by 48 bitmap, but it splits into 6x6, 8x8 tiles, and that's what we're going to have to deal with this example. You see, at the start of the code here, the define tiles routine is exactly the same as last time. It's the identical code. What's not the same, though, is the actual bit that draws the character to the screen, because last time we just needed to get one character to the screen, but this time we need to do a sequence, and we need to draw 6 tiles to the screen, and then move back to the bottom left, just below the start point, and draw 7 and onwards. So we're doing this kind of zigzag, left to right, top to bottom, a bit like a typewriter, drawing those consecutive tile numbers to the screen. So here we're defining an XY start position, a width and a height, a tile start number, and we're running fill area with tiles. And here it is. So this is going to draw our tiles to the screen. The first thing we're doing is using this getVDPScreenPos function, which is the same one we used before, just selects from an XY position a memory address, and then what we're going to do is we're going to write consecutive tile numbers in D. So this is only going to work up to 255. If you wanted to fill the entire screen with a unique image where there was no repetition, 255 tiles won't do it for you, but it's good enough for this little example. So you just need to do a little bit of upgrading if you needed to do 512 tiles or something. So we're writing a 0 to the top byte here, and we're writing the tile number to the low byte here, and we're just incrementing the tile number each time. Once we've done a line, we're jumping back up here, moving our YPOS down one, recalculating our screen position, and we're just repeating until all the tiles are drawn. And when all the tiles are drawn, we'll have this little character here. So that's very nice. So there we go. That's really all it takes to get a simple bitmap on the screen. Now with the NES, unfortunately, the vblank routine was a bit crude. It would actually wait for a new vblank every time. So when we were waiting for vblank, it was getting quite slow, but with the Super Nintendo, it's not so bad. It will actually detect if we're still in vblank, if we're kind of halfway through. Now, ideally, you would use a buffer as well. I have covered that as well. I think I covered that in the platform specific series, and it was also in Grime 6502. So if you want to see more of that kind of thing, you know, please take a look at those, because I've already done this content in there. So at this stage, we're not going to cover it in this one. So anyway, I hope you found that interesting. That's all we're going to cover in today's episode of the simple series. We're going to come back to this example though later on, and we're going to add some joystick control to that smiley. We're going to move it around the screen according to the joypad. So again, this is all about trying to get the simplest example I can provide to you that you could use as a template to start writing a little game of your own. I hope you found this interesting. If you have, you know, please like and subscribe. You know, there's lots of other content on my channel that may interest you if you're into your Super Nintendo. I've already got a lot of other content in the platform specific series, and we've done that Hello World where I showed you how to create a cartridge with an assembler. But aside from that, I've also got Z80, 6502 and 68000 tutorials on a lot of different systems. You know, maybe you prefer to move to the Genesis or something. I'm also doing ARM and 8086 now, and I'll be doing RISC-V very soon. So I'm trying to cover all of the platforms, all the different CPUs as best as I can, and give a real variety of content for you if you're like me, quite curious about all these different assembly languages that you missed out on when you were younger. So, you know, please follow along and have a look around to see what interests you. But whatever you do, I hope you'll enjoy the Super Nintendo, and I hope you enjoy programming in general. So thanks for watching today, and goodbye.